Thank you. Thank you very much. I'm Nataline's mom. My voice is a little gone. I haven't cried. I can't cry. It's very difficult. I know I raised her really well. We prayed a lot. She's gone through a lot. And before I continue, I want to really thank every one of you. I want to thank Senator John Edwards, and I wish you the best, and I hope you become our president, and the Armenian community is going to back you up. And thank you, Elizabeth, also. My daughter was first diagnosed when she was 14 years old, and insurance companies kept on sending us through different hospitals, from Holy Cross to Cedars-Sinai to Children's Hospital. 2 years of after chemotherapy, she was in remission, maintenance. It was beautiful, 10 months. We had a sweet 16 party for her. It was the best thing. Everything she wanted in life, we gave her. We tried to give her everything. Then after 10 months, they told us that her leukemia came back. So at that time, with God's help and the doctors, they checked on my son to see if he's a match. And he was a perfect match. We were so happy. Then the day came that she was going to get the transplant. A couple of weeks before, the insurance company called me and said, honey, you need to go to UCLA because this is how we're going to pay. If you go to State Children's Hospital, we're not going to pay. So we went ahead. We went to UCLA, did the bone marrow transplant. 1 week later, complications started. One day my daughter was yellow. She had jaundice. So they told me that she has to go to ICU. She went to ICU. 3 weeks. She loves Christmas. I promised her she's going to be home for Christmas. She made it home with God and the angels. I just couldn't bring her back home. My son did everything. He's our hero. He did everything possible to save her, but the insurance company kept on denying us. They called me one day. I'm in the lobby. I'm shivering. I can't go upstairs and see her. I love my daughter. I feel empty inside. My heart, there's a hole. I don't know any insurance company if they are able to repair this. You guys, this is not about only my daughter, Nataline. It's about the whole world, every one of you. This could happen to any of us again and again. We have to put a stop on these people. They're driving our car. We own a car. We have insurance. They're driving it. It's not real. It's not fair. This is not right. We have to make a change. And they cannot stop us. And they cannot tell us who's going to live and who's going to die. We were in Glendale the same day, December 20th. Little that you knew, that I knew my daughter was going to pass away, and I always thought positive. And we went and we yelled and screamed and everything. Finally, they told us, we will make an exception. What does that mean? That means only Nataline can live and not you guys? It's not right. We fought them. But what about the other parents that cannot speak? They don't have the community. They don't have the churches to back them up. So what's going to happen? They're just going to go home and then they're going to bury their kid and that's it? No, we're going to fight. My daughter was in Armenian Youth Federation. She is a strong person, strong, beautiful girl. She always wanted to get involved in this politics. She wants to just me get involved. This is for her. I am not a public speaker, you guys. I'm a mom. I work. I have a full-time job, but she's my priority. But right now, I'm here for her and for every kid, every mom and dad out there. We have to make a change. We have to vote for the perfect president because in the past, no one can help us. This is it. We have to vote for Mr. Edwards. We have to. So I want to thank you. There's so much I could say, but right now, obviously, I didn't write anything down. This is from my heart. I'm going to pass this to my son and then my husband. And I want to thank you from my heart. And Nataline, I love you. I'm here for you.
Wow. I'm not a public speaker as well. This is amazing. I want to thank Senator Edwards for having us out here, first of all, first and foremost. Second of all, I can just tell you, a month ago, I'm sitting in my couch recovering from my bone marrow transplant that I had on a day before Thanksgiving. I'm recovering, you know, I can't do anything. I'm just watching TV and right now I'm here in front of all you guys, and the world is watching. Senator Edwards is mentioning my sister's name. Michael Moore is mentioning my sister's name. This is a movie I'm living right now. This is not happening to me right now. And you know what? It really is happening. And it's happening to other people, too, at the same time. But I guess I'm speaking on their behalf, because that's the least I can do right now for that other people that are just, they can't do what we're doing right now. They're just sitting at home, they're crying, and they'll get over it, they'll forget it, or they'll move on, you know? But no. The number one reason why we're here right now in front of all of you, why I'm on this microphone right now, is because 30 minutes before my sister passed away in that ICU room, I looked at her in her eyes. I looked in her eyes, and honest to God, I promised her I'm going to live my life for her. I promised her that everyone in the world is going to know her story. Everyone is going to know her story, her struggle, her fight. Everyone's going to know it. And Senator Edwards has been saying this for the past couple weeks, change. I promised her that change. I'm like, you know what? The world has to change. It's not. I'm speaking to her. She's not responding. Even though she's not responding, she's in a coma. She's not responding, but I'm telling her, like, this is not right. It's going to change. It has to happen. And then right now, look at this. I'm here. I mean, I knew I was going to fight the second I stepped out of that room, but I didn't know it was going to be this quick. I mean, I'm turning 22 in a couple of days. I thought, okay, this is going to be one of my goals. I'm in my 30s. I'm going to be out in Washington, you know. I'll know more about the system and how things work. But just December 20th, she passed away. And from that moment on, the second I stepped out of that room, I swear I felt so much stronger as a person. I feel she's with us right now, and that's what's giving me the power to speak to you guys right now. I didn't write anything down. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you, all, everybody is here right now, and also those nurses, they do a wonderful job. All the hospitals, they deserve 100% everything. You guys deserve whatever you guys get paid for it. You guys deserve more. I want to thank you, Senator, for whatever you're doing for America. I'm not going to say for my daughter anymore. You're doing for America. This is a very important issue. We're going to keep Natalie's name alive. We're going to fight back, and we're going to win. If the people choose, they will win. Only people can win. President himself cannot win. People can make president win. So that's my message. I want to also thank my wife and my son. He's a hero. He donated his bone marrow to my daughter. He gave her a chance to live, but Cigna didn't. They denied us 2 times. Our doctors, they signed 4 or 5 times. 2 times they denied us. Cigna cannot make decision people's life. We have to change. So people fight back for that. It's for you guys. I'm telling you. Promise. I promise my daughter we're going to fight back, and you guys fight back for that too. Please, it's for you guys. I don't want to take too much time from Senator either, but I want to say something. I give my daughter 17 years, her life, best I can do. I'm a middle class man. I work every day. I work whenever I can to support my family. That's my job. I'm a father, like you guys are. You have kids, you have to take care of them. First thing, they're your kids, and then your secondary. So I did my whatever I supposed to do. But I bought insurance through my company. My daughter got sick.